Dead man walking down the green mile.
on the green mile. You screwed it up. Dead man walking on the green mile.
I always do. Because what I really wanted to say was, if heartache brought pain. No, that's the third one. Boom, go to that. Boom, boom. No, boom. Yeah, that's right. Now listen close. If heartache brought pain, you shut up. Okay. In love's crazy game, I'd be a legend in my time. Now you got it, right? Because you relaxed.
Yeah.
When if loneliness meant world acclaim, and everyone would know my name, I'd be a legend in my time. Old Hank Snow tune.
A legend in my time.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event. moment you've all been waiting for, the thousands in attendance and the millions around the world watching on air, online. It's the live from the Northwest, the really big old-time radio medicine show, Three Chords and the Truth, starring Molly Griffin and her old dog, Doo.
You hear that lonesome whippoorwill sound?
Silence of a falling star lights up a purple sky. And as I wonder where you are, I'm so lonesome I could. Baby, I'm so lonesome I could cry, Ma. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Different ways first European settlers approached the Indians inhabiting. You know, the Puritans
the Native
come
Americans?
In down there in
yes.
Plymouth Rock.
Yeah.
They said, they've been kicking the shit out of us back there because of our religion. And we don't like it anymore, so we come here to kick the shit out of you.
Yeah, but they all like starved to death. No.
Oh, I know it was terrible.
And the Indians took pity on them and showed them how to grow corn and stuff.
And then they killed them all.
And then they killed them all.
Yeah, I know. And
that's why we have Thanksgiving.
I wanted to show you the different. But of course, those are my people too, because I got all these mixed. You know, I'm a mutt.
Yeah.
It's all a mutt of the good territories, though. Because that would be the English mutt part. They are the worst. Then you got the Irish and the Norwegians, right?
Yeah.
Okay, but then I was thinking about the Norwegians because they came quite a bit earlier.
Yeah.
And when they got a Newfoundland, and what you know what they did? They went like this. They saw the Indians, and they went like, "Hey, are you guys using this?" And those Indians said, "No, it's okay. You can use it." And then some other Indians, it was probably the next generation, said, "Why did you guys leave those blood turkeys out there? We don't want them. We're the new people. And so they come and they started fighting. Mm-hmm. And my people went, oh, okay, we're out of here. So you can go to the records in Iceland, and you can see the message written down was, this land is inhabited, and they can defend it.
Nice.
Isn't that hilarious?
Nice.
Oh, yeah, baby. You know what I like. You Chantilly lace, baby. Okay. What do you got now?
I got big. Oh, we got to take the ride.
Oh, take a quick ride. We got to take a limo ride.
Ladies and gentlemen, step outside the door to your mind because there's an old black Cadillac limo waiting just outside, and we're going to take a ride.
It's like a Xanadu Valley pleasure dome decree in the backseat of that limo. I've been in the backseat of limos, Mom.
Me too, Dad.
Counting like hundreds of thousands of cash. Tell them we won the election,
Mom. We're gonna take a ride. Dad, we're gonna take a ride.
Oh, yeah. I'll pass a honky tonk.
And pass the county line.
To the amber waves of grain.
To
the field of dreams.
With the big brown.
Who's coming out of the field tonight, Mom?
Hey, it's Johnny Cash, Dad.
The John, he always coming out, Mom.
He taught the weeping willow,
I'm
Dad.
I'm glad he's so popular, still popular.
He is very popular, man.
Well, I taught that weeping willow how to cry. Showed that cloud out of cup of a clear blue sky. Oh man, you know tears I cried, but that woman gonna blood you big river woman. I'm gonna sit right here until I die.
I'm gonna sit right here until I die.
Well, I met her accidentally in St. Paul, Minnesota. Told me up every time I heard that draw, heard the southern draw. Oh man, you took my dream back downstream, go boating in the Davenport, and I followed you, big river, when you call.
Followed you, big river, when you call.
Well, you took me to St. Louis later on down the river. Greta said she's been here, boy, but she's gone, boy, she's gone. Well, I found her trail in Memphis, and she just walked up the block. She raised a few eyebrows, she went down alone.
She raised a few eyebrows, and she went down alone.
Well, don't you batten down my Baton Rouge, River Queen, rolling on. Take that woman on down to New Orleans, down to New Orleans. Oh, go on, I've had enough. Dump my blues way down in the gulf. I said she loves you, big river, more than me.
She loves you, big river, more than me.
Oh, I thought the weeping willow had to cry.
Showed that cloud how to cover up a clear blue sky.
Oh man, you know tears I cry, but that woman, they're gonna flood you, big river. And I'm gonna sit right here until I die. Either that, or I'm gonna sit right here until I see a big eight wheeler.
Big eight wheeler.
You know, it goes here. Oh, there's a big wheeler moving down the track. I mean, true loving daddy ain't come by, and I'm moving on.
He's moving on.
I'm a rolling on.
Hey, rolling on.
Keep a shoveling the coal, keep rattling the roll, keep moving on. Well, you switch the engine, I ain't got time for no traveling woman on my main lines. I keep moving on. You did your daddy wrong. You had to laugh on me, and I said to Bree, and I'm moving on. Let's go, Ma.
All right, Dad.
listen to me. You know I got a pretty mama down in Tennessee. Keep moving me on.
Keep moving on.
Keep a rolling on.
Keep rolling on.
Keep a shoveling the coal. Keep a rattling the road. Keep moving on. Well, one day, baby, when you've had your play, gonna want your daddy, but your daddy's gonna say, keep moving on. Stayed away too long.
Stayed away too long.
You had a laugh on me, and I said to Bree, and I'm moving on.
Get back in the limo now. We got to finish the ride.
Oh, yeah. Are we ever going to get there? I think we should make that the show, Mall. That we end there at the up the out of the thing for the last song. You know?
Yeah.
The finale.
Yeah.
When we sing, Lord, I hope this day is good.
Sing it, Daddy.
Or the other one, hope you had the time of your life. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Good finishers, Mall. Or glory days.
Well, I pass you by.
Or how about Uncle Willie's?
Well, hello there.
Yeah. Ain't it funny how time slips away, Mom?
Mm-hmm.
Sure as hell is.
All right, let's get finish this ride up, Dad. Or do you want to leave it till the end? No,
that's funny about how the settler's coming in, isn't it, Mom?
That is good, Dad. We should finish the ride, Dad.
And then a few years later, one of those Norwegian settlers said, really Irish Norwegian, said, I found the impetus of the human brain. Go on down to Patreon, find out about it. Hello, Mo.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What? I'm just having fun.
The continuing story of the Irish and the Norwegians in North America. Come
it's
on.
Good. It's good. It's good.
You know what's so good about that damn thing?
Mm.
It's got three doors. That's all.
Three doors.
Under one door is purpose and meaning, growth and development. That's a door.
Yeah.
That's a door.
That's a door.
The second door? Order, security, and what?
Order and security.
Yeah.
That's a door.
Fair play.
Oh, damn.
That's in there, too. That's in that room.
That's a door.
There's a lot of things in the room, but you got to go up and, you know, I'll just tell you this, okay?
Uh-huh.
The croc, your croc,
yeah.
The reptilian brain,
mm-hmm.
It's like a power amp. The power amp is just the power.
Mm.
And your higher mind
mm-hmm.
is the preamp.
Mm-hmm.
And it's really, really powerful, and it's going to get its way. But it wants you to cooperate. It wants you to get the details. Okay, this is how we're going to do the purpose and meaning and the growth and development.
Yeah.
That's your, you're the captain of the ship.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But it's really good to know how it works,
yeah.
How it all works.
Yeah.
Jesus, jumping Joseph. Have I sang a hymn yet?
You didn't say the third door. We were doing a thing, and you interrupted
well,
it.
Well, the third door, of course, covers the whole rest of it, and that's just synchronization with nature, with all that is natural. So, you know, we're exactly the same physiological specimens. This is where health and fitness comes into it.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly the same physiological system, people, that we were 15,000, 20,000 years ago in the bush and in the caves. And we were working all the time and doing all kinds of
people
crap.
People around, family around.
And you can't just take that
there.
Physiological thing and slap it on a couch with a remote control.
In an apartment by itself.
And give it a lot of choices.
Yeah. Too many choices.
Too many choices.
That's a door.
That'll make you sick. The choices. Too many choices. Okay, is that enough preaching?
Yeah.
That's good because I'm in pain now. This is a podcast.
Okay.
This is the heaviest podcast on the planet.
Yeah.
Do you know what this is, Molly? It's a finger pointing at the moon. Yeah, baby.
<You're> insane. Are we going to finish the ride or are we going to sing a song?
Song.
Okay. Get in a G sharp. We're going to do such.
Oh, we haven't finished the ride?
No. That's what I said.
Okay, we will. We'll stretch it out to almost to the end.
All right.
Okay, what is this one?
G sharp. Suds in the bucket. Suds in the bucket.
Oh, my God. You expect a man to do a woman's song like and I haven't even tried for years.
We've done it recently.
No.
Multiple times.
She was in the backyard, say it was a little past nine. When a prince pulled out on pickup truck. Well, folks should have known that it was only just a matter of time. When you're old enough and you can't stop love. You left a note on the screen door, sorry, but I got to go. That was all she wrote. Mama's heart was broke. That was all she wrote. And so the story goes. Now daddy's in the kitchen staring out the window and scratching and racking his brain. I got 18 years just up and walk away. And the ponytail girl grows up to be a woman and she's gone in the blink of an eye. All she left the suds in the bucket and the clothes hanging out on the line.
She left the suds in the bucket and the clothes hanging out on the line.
Why don't you wonder what the preacher's gonna preach about Sunday morning? Cause nothing quite like this has happened here before. Really must have been a lucky, yeah, sweet talking son of a gun. For such a grounded girl. Just up and run. But you can't pass time.
You can't pass time.
And you can't stop love.
You can't stop love.
Now the baby's in the beauty shop. Gossip going on. Stop sipping on the pink lemonade. I got 18 years just up and walk away. Little ponytail girl grows up to be a woman and she's gone in the blink of an eye. Oh, she left the suds in the bucket and the clothes hanging out on the line.
She left the suds in the bucket and the clothes hanging out on the line.
Our pretty little bear Peter hanging out the window and they're headed up to Vegas tonight. I got 18 years just up and walk away. A little ponytail girl grows up to be a woman and she's gone in the blink of an eye. Oh, she left the suds in the bucket and the clothes hanging out on the line.
She left the suds in the bucket and the clothes hanging out on the line.
Yes, she was in the backyard, say it was a little past night. When a prince pulled out.
White pickup truck.
Well, the folks should have known it was only just a matter of time. Plenty old enough. When you can't stop love. When you can't pass time. And you can't stop love. Oh no, you can't pass time. And you can't stop love. But hope you
I feel like a hot dog. I was thinking about a wiener. You remember in the cuckoo's nest? He says, the ball game is on. Mm. He says, somebody give me a fucking wiener before I die. He was talking about a hot dog. Only in America, Mom.
Aww.
They like very similar things in Germany, you know? They're like the sausages down there.
Yes.
You know what I was really, really shocked about in Germany?
What?
Because I used to do big herring business over there, you know?
So yeah.
That's where I learned the story about it. Sometimes it's better to go it alone.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Why?
Because I was kind of big shot, and I took a Danish guy with me because I didn't speak no languages, right?
Oh, he was like your translator.
He was my, and not only that, he was in the fish business, so he knew the fish business too.
Right.
And he could give me all the inside dope.
Yeah.
I thought this is you know, this is showing how things work out, right?
Yeah.
We lands in Amsterdam, and I'm staying at this Amstel hotel, and he's somewhere else. And then he's gonna show me the first Dutch beer, the best Dutch beer. We just went down this lounge because it's Amstel. This is where the Queen stays, right?
Yeah.
And this outdoor place where you sit, and the canal goes by, and all the people in the wooden shoes and.
Yeah.
And the girls in the windows, you know what I mean? And the weed and the coffee shops.
Yeah.
No, we're sitting there and we're having this beer, and I got to admit, he wasn't lying about that. He's a Dane, eh? He's about 6'4",
yeah.
Gorgeous looking guy, kind of perfect.
Yeah.
That's what I was going to tell you later, how shocked I was about how good-looking people were in Germany, because I was brought up in the war movies, and the Germans were always these terrible things. But when I got there, I went, oh, super rich. Like, you know, Catherine in CSI?
Yeah.
Yeah, look at her. She's German, right?
Yeah. Anyway, you guys are drinking the beer?
There's a lot of good-looking people all over the place. I'm not, like, standing up for Germans.
Yeah.
You guys, the Anglo-Saxon, you got a little German.
Dad, Grandpa Simpson, you guys are drinking the beer.
Yeah.
This is why.
Then he goes to the schnapps, and then he's taking me out on Amsterdam, on the town for the evening.
Yeah.
And it was well. I am like a drunken weirdness. You know.
Yeah.
It's all hazy to me. Mm-hmm. What I remember was that we got separated.
Mm-hmm.
And I ended up back at the Amstel, and I got to bed because I had to go do these huge, we're talking about like
business
millions
deals.
Of dollars here.
Yeah.
And the next day, and I get back into bed, and I'm in bed for about 90 minutes. I mean, I got back at like 5 o'clock or something.
Yeah.
I'm in bed for about 90 minutes. And the telephone rings. And the cute little voice from downstairs, the accent, you know, Mr. Griffin. The Amsterdam police just called. They've got Mr. Houseguard. He's charged with attempted murder of a prostitute. And I'm sick. Eh? I'm so sick. Now, I'm telling you right now, it was a con thing where the taxi drivers and the hookers, but he got with the hooker.
Yeah.
And she had a thing going on with the taxi drivers.
Right.
And like, and she would knock the window, smack the window out and claim that he hit her and all because he refused to give her the money.
Right.
Stupid bastard. He, you know what I mean? Them Danes, they're real dumb, aren't they?
Yeah.
They're like the richest, happiest people on earth. They got so much money, they're giving all their immigrants full board tickets and cash and everything to take a trip home. The only thing is, one way.
That's one way to do it. It's probably the nicer way.
Yeah, that's right. Just send them home with lots of money. So they can start businesses in their countries and everything can be cool.
So what happened to your Danish friend?
Listen to this, Mo. I'm going to tell you the worst part of that story now.
Mm-hmm.
I had to go into this room in the police, in the whatever that is, Amsterdam Police Department or whatever.
Yeah.
And there's detectives sitting all, there's a boardroom, big board table.
Yeah.
And detectives all sitting on each side of the board table. And down at the end is Sven Houseguard, my dude. And he looks so bad. I'm telling I think I had to do most of the talking there too because he looked like he was going to pass out. But guess what it boiled down to? And this was the worst part. It's coming quickly. I had to call his wife, who's a beautiful woman here, in a beautiful home, lovely children. I mean, these are super race Danes, right? Great Danes, tall daughters. I had to call her and tell her the facts. Needless to say, it would have been better to go it alone. Go it alone. That's the name of that story.
But he got off.
Yeah, but he never helped me a bit. That cost me a fortune to bring that son of a bitch. And he was always arguing with me about how the Danes were superior to the Norwegians.
Yeah.
Right? And I said, you guys just get your ass over to Newfoundland, you stupid bastard. You're too busy trying to conquer us.
Yeah.
And they did.
Yeah.
I think they tried to get Iceland, too, because you know they got Greenland.
Yeah. I do.
Iceland is really good. That's where the girls, they want to have sex with you first before they waste their time on you.
Mm-hmm.
You see, they've got empathy.
Yeah.
They can feel whether you're right. What do you got going? Okay, the game of all games with the show of all shows, and Molly has just picked a wonderful song that relates to everything we just said.
I can't stop loving you.
I can't stop loving you. I said I'm made of my mind. Living memories of a lonesome time. I can't stop wanting you. Oh, it's just useless to say. So I'll just live my life in dreams of yesterday.
Dreams of yesterday.
Those happy hours.
Those happy hours
that we once knew.
That we once knew.
So long ago.
So long ago.
Still make me blue.
Still make me blue.
Oh, they say that time.
They say that time.
They heal a broken heart.
Heals a broken heart.
Never the time has stood
still.
Since we've been apart, now I can't stop loving you. I said I made up my mind to live in memories of the lonesome kind. Now I can't stop wanting you. It's just useless say. So I'll just live my life in dreams of yesterday. Yesterday, all my troubles seemed so far away. Now it looks as though they're here to stay. Oh, I believe in Merle Haggard. Today I started loving you again. Now I'm right back where I really always been. I got over you just long enough to let my heart ache, man. And then today started loving you again.
Yeah, today I started loving you again.
Oh, what a fool I was to think I could get by. Yet to come,
and that crying time for me just begun.
And then today I started loving you again.
Now
I'm right back where I really always been. I got over you just long enough to let my heart ache, man. And then today I started loving you again. And then today I started loving you again. And then today I started I never squeezed her once all show. What the hell's going on, you guys? Always tell me when the pig doesn't get out here because she never. We need to hang her from here so I can see her. Hang the pig. All right, here she's got. They're going to get the star of the show now. Well, on call says she built sweet. She got everything old Uncle John needs, baby. Hey, hey, oh, baby. Ooh, was it, baby? You wanna help me jump on now? Well, long tall Sally. Here comes long tall Sally. Oh, long tall Sally. She's all right. And she,
oh, how much is that dog in the window?
Oh, man, the one with the waggly tail. She got a waggly tail. I said, how much is that doggy in the window? Oh, man, I do hope that doggy's for sale.
Because if she is, we're going to get Roger Miller, and we're going to go walking
in sunshine, singing a little sunshine song. You got to put a smile upon your face as if there's nothing wrong. Poppy, oh, poo. You got to think about a good time. You had a long time. Think about beginning to mind your worries and you go walking in the sunshine. Sing a little sunshine song. You go walking in the sunshine song. You go walking in the sunshine.
Sing a little sunshine song.
Oh, oh. Baby, your life will never be the same. Go down to Griffin Heart at Patreon if you want to go down to the happiest place on earth, Molly. Cutting edge behavioral science. We answer all questions here, there, and everywhere. Keep the cards and letters coming in. We'll see you in the bunny papers and have